5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team back. Radiant team pick.
Slada.
Dire team pick.
Dark Seer.
Dire team pick.
Puck.
Radiant team pick. Dire team back. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
All right, hello everyone, and welcome back to the Pro Dota Cup US Season 6 Group Stages. This is game number 2 of a best of 2 between Pain Gaming and Evernova. I'm going to be your caster Annie, aka Android, bringing you guys the hype, and I am being joined once again by my lovely analyst PQMZ. What's up, dude?
Hello, hello.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I really like the puck here. Like you mentioned, Oracle kind of screws up the Darkseer a little bit, but should still be able to have an impact here. Some synergy that I've actually seen a lot recently, especially in the CIS scene, is picking up the Darkseer, throwing him on a Spirit Breaker. It's really deadly. Yeah, well, cheese partners, no more. Pain Gaming going on to their third pick here. If they want to go for some all-out teamfight, I mean, what else could they pick up? They do still have the Tidehunter as an option, but it'd be kind of hard to run him as a position 4. You really want to be able to throw him in the offlane, so what other big teamfighty heroes are Pain Gaming looking for right now?
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
That sounds pretty fun here. So Evernova, they're going into their third pick. They still do need a secondary support. They need a mid laner. What mid laner just destroys Puck? Are we looking at a Windrunner? Are we looking at a Quap? Ooh, I like that a lot. Alright, so they're taking their time with their third pick here, dipping heavily into reserve time. I think it might have been that Beastmaster that just got banned out, so Pain throwing them for a little bit of a loop. Evernova's still looking for an offlaner here, unless they're going to run the Slardar once again up in that offlane. Do you think it's going to be Core Slardar, or did they do a good enough job with him last game in the safe lane? Or offlane, rather.
Witch Doctor!
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Alrighty here, so Pain Gaming looks like they are going to be heading on to their fourth pick. I'd like to see them pick up a secondary support here. They can save their core for last here, but they do have the Sven at their disposal. Sven could be pretty good up against the Oracle, just keep him stun locked, so Oracle's not able to get off any sort of helping, healing spells. Yeah, and I like the fact that Lifestealer has that built-in BKB right from level, 2 or 3 whenever he picks it up. He's going to be able to go in, not fearing the Witch Doctor cask whatsoever. Oh, that's a good pick, though. Evernova, they're not holding anything back. We talked about what wrecks a Puck in the mid lane. Unbelievable quantities of damage is what wrecks a Puck. That's gonna be pretty dirty here now. Are Evernova looking towards the ultra late game, and how does a Shadow Fiend compare to a late game Lifestealer? Okay, here.
Imbus spirit.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Man, that Ember Spirit is a risky pick. Picking an Ember into a Puck that has a built-in silence, that's going to be kind of difficult if Ember Spirit's the frontliner of the fight. But think that Evernova may have the damage to pull this off. They're just going to have to delay Pain Gaming's push and Pain Gaming's fight for, you know, 20 minutes in. Then Evernova have a super solid lineup, so much damage. Shadow Fiend and Ember Spirit are a little bit glass cannony, but Pain Gaming, they're going to continue this snowball strat, putting King RD on the Legion Commander. Definitely changing things up a little bit here, but do you think that's the right play up against heroes with such high damage potential? So support Lifestealer, though. It's gonna not build into a really aggressive carry. I think they're gonna put all their eggs in the Legion basket. I've seen 4DR play Lifestealer, and he did play it kinda soft, but of course that was several patches ago. We'll see if he's gonna be going building up those hitty items, or, you know, he could just kinda be build up some auras, hop into an ancient creep, and be the pusher. It should. Alright, so we've got a big clump of Pain heroes here. Just gonna be a solo Darkseer down bottom. Does Jubaloo have any hope of taking this rune, or is it just gonna be a clean 1-1 split again? Alright, as the horn sounds, no blood. Yeah, that is going to be a really fantastic ward. And alright, there's going to be King RD getting close to the rune. Lanaro goes through. We'll go ahead, grab up the bounty rune, and hop straight to the mid lane, not wasting any time. We'll be able to get a little bit of a block off as well. So Puck, such a comfort hero for Lanaro. I've seen him play it a dozen times, and every single time it is certainly something to behold. Up here in the top lane, we have a duel so far of 4DR and Lilkin, so is this going to be a Jungle Legion core life? What is happening? Well, I hope she gets big enough. Yeah, I definitely think it does. I think the problem won't be in getting her levels or gold, just getting her those kills. She's going to have to rotate, and well, hopefully she gets an early enough blink that it'll be well timed enough to get those kills before anyone really has the tools to deal with that. Down bottom, we do have Juan doing his best to go ahead and dispel all those obnoxious Darkseer Ion Shells, but I don't know, I think Jubaloo's still going to get exactly what he needs out of the lane. Yeah, I mean, Oracle. He's actually going to be going in, trying to get a kill here onto the Oracle, but Oracle is just going to be able to walk away. Has those brown boots, Darkseer, no such luck, so the movement speed not in his favor. Going to be just a really annoying lane for the Darkseer. He will be forced back by the tickly hits of the Oracle, but like you said, he doesn't really need to be that scared. There's not a whole lot of kill potential coming out of Evernova. Oh, top lane. Looks like Slardar could be in some trouble. He will cast the sprint. He might want to get Lilkin here, but Lilkin goes in with the Hex. They've got the rage here. Hook could be in some serious trouble. Derp Derp doing what he can to keep everyone healthy, and it looks like it will be enough as Lion is going to be the first blood here. Slardar picking off a nice pick and now doing some little more harass onto 4DR. Slardar feeling very good about that. He got low, but he did have that salve in his inventory to get himself right back up to fighting shape. Yeah, I mean, I thought the Earth Spike would be able to do more than it was able to, but it only lasts for so long. Now, 4DR is going to be getting some nice munches onto the Slardar, but Slardar will be picking up Phase Boots, or rather, Tranquils, quite shortly. Going to be flying in that Ring of Protection. Down bottom. Dubaloo gonna be in a little bit of trouble, does get Searing Chained up, so he's not able to surge away. That's gonna be a nice kill for the Ember Spirit. We talked about them not having kill protection, but now the Searing Chains, that's gonna be a huge impact. Now Darkseer cannot just run away from the damage. Yeah, I mean, Slardar, he's getting kind of low there. He doesn't really have a whole lot of regen, but the Tranquil Boots will come off cooldown now, and he's going to heal back up to full health. He's going to be looking here. Does he have the tools to take out an LC? Looks like he's going to be following him around, maybe trying to bring in the puck to get something rolling here, but, I mean, he's pinged her out. He now knows exactly what's going on here, and does he try to jump? They're bringing in the Witch Doctor. Witch Doctor does have that cask that'll bounce around. Witch Doctor does not have a point in the Maledict. Now, the Courier coming through, that could be an even bigger kill, but they're going to focus their attention onto the LC. Cask will bounce to the Jungle Creep. Great timing on that cask. Now, the Body Blocks come through, and Shadow Fiend wants to go in. Looks like the One Raise will secure a kill, and that's going to be Shadow Fiend getting a much needed head start in this lane up against a Puck. Yeah, it's not a good day to be on Pain Gaming, but how can they get themselves back in this? Their level 6s are going to start to come out relatively soon. Puck is just about able to take over the edge, and I mean, they do have pretty strong team fight. What does their ideal team fight look like? Puck out. Oh. Oh, top lane, we do have a Hex up onto Ho-Kay as he's looking through. Hook will be able to get out of that fish form, and it's going to get a nice crush here onto 4DR. 4DR does have that rage ready to go. Will he cast a Dream Coil onto 2? This is going to be huge. It looks like Pain Gaming might be able to get themselves back in this game. Can they cancel the TP? They're not able to, but they get a much-needed kill onto that Slardar. That falls back to the well for another 20 seconds, and Pain are able to get a little bit of free farm out of the lane. I mean, she's trying to go in. Oh, the duel ends just before the Shadow Fiend goes down, so she's not going to get that extra duel victory. Pretty unfortunate. Yeah, but it... Yeah, I mean, you do want to start snowballing up that, dual damage just so she does hit a little bit harder. It would make the jungle clear just that much easier, but well, for now she's gonna walk back to the base, collect her items, go for some mana, and you know, Pain Gaming, they're still kicking. They got 2 kills up top, pretty important getting the Slardar down. They got the Shadow Fiend down as well, so I mean, they're still in this. It's a very steep hill to climb, though. Up top, 40R might be going down once again. Does pop into the rage to prevent the cask from landing. And that hook, he's going through. He does have the crush ready to go, but walks in just a little bit too deeply. Looks like the death ward will go and will get immediately canceled on the duel onto Derp Derp. This is going to be a great kill if they can get it, but he's still alive. The Voodoo Restoration doing too much work on the back lines. They do get the kill with the arrows from the Legion Commander, and they are able to get the Fishman himself as well. So it's going to be a 2-for-1 as Darkseer falls in the bottom lane, but overall, still definitely worth that for Paint Gaming. Alright, switching over to our net worth chart here. Shadow Fiend, the big boy leader. Ember Spirit, we haven't talked a whole lot about him because he's really just been sitting back getting almost unlimited free farm here. He has 3 kills to his name. He's got the items that he needs to start being useful. And in terms of overall XP and gold, it's pretty close to zero. But I think with the gold being distributed onto the Ember and the Shadow Fiend, those two heroes could definitely carry you into late game. Oh, they're looking for a jump here. Lion does have his Finger of Death, so they could get some nice blow-up damage, but Legion Commander, no Blink Dagger, just gets kited around right into the open jaws of the Radiant. There's gonna be a Dream Quail by Lenara, but they're not able to get the duel off. It's only level 1. Now Lilkin in some serious trouble. His Slick's just ripping through him. Looks like they will get the kill onto the Shadow Fiend, but they do have to trade it for the Lifestealer and the Lion. Now there is gonna be King RD getting very, very low. Last click down, and looks like he will end up falling Oracle, just nuking out the damage there with that Fortune's End. So it is gonna be a 3-for-1 trade. Probably not worth it considering two of your cores went down there.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Alright, so with a little bit of a break in the action here, Evernova, they've got a slight lead in terms of net worth, but like we talked about before, it's distributed very well in the most advantageous place for Evernova to have it, which is getting their Shadow Fiend beefy, getting him his items, and getting Ember Spirit, his safe, secure farm. Oh god, this Ember Spirit's got a double damage rune in the bottle. He is gonna be able to just slice through whatever comes his way. Speaking of vehicles for Lifestealer, he will go in. Nice rage here, dodging out some of the damage with pure damage from Witch Doctor's ult. Might be enough. He hops into a creep. He gets out with full health. Now, it looks like the Oracle will be the first casualty falling down. The Dream Quail connects onto Derp Derp. Derp Derp should be going down. The Voodoo Restoration can only keep him alive for so long. Now, okay. Going through the trees here. Now, Hook, he will be able to slither away to safety, but that is a costly engage. They lost 2. They could have lost 3, but still, Pain give up very little resources for that. They drop a couple ulties, but overall, clean gold and clean XP in their pockets. Alright. That's pretty solid there for Slicks. Lix is fresh out of mana here. He's got enough for like one sleight of fist. He's got enough for one remnant, but he's going to be drinking up his bottle, getting a little bit more out of that. And Dire, they're looking for some initiation point. But again, King RD just doesn't have the money for a blink and feeling kind of flimsy hitting for sub 100. So there's very few dual targets that she can go in on that she feels completely safe. I mean, they might try. They've got the wall, but no points in vacuum. That's a very quirky build to me, unless you're trying to use the wall as a zoning tool. Usually you really only level up the wall when you've got at least 2 points in vacuum. Oh, hook going through. They're just gonna rip apart Lil' Kin. Poor little guy. He's one of my friends in the lobbies. We chat to each other, but that was just not safe for work. Now the wall will come through. Jubaloo trying to do what he can to zone everyone out, but it's not gonna be enough. Dreamcoil connecting onto a bunch, but Radiant are perfectly content just sitting here, shredding through the Dire's heroes. The cask will end up bouncing back and forth between King RD and 4DR. They're gonna go down, both of them heading straight to the grave. The tower will be a nice little cherry on top of a successful fight. Only the Puck gets out alive, sitting here on the back lines of the fight, watching his whole team go up in flames. It feels like Pain are just radically falling more and more behind. Looking at the net worth charts, it's just accelerating in Evernova's favor. Oh, Lil Kin, no! My friend, to hell and back to hell and back. Alright, 4DR will go through, will take a crush right to the face. He has the armlet toggled on, is gonna be able to rage away from the cast bouncing to the neutral creeps, and now Hook, he's looking for something, will cast that negative armor, but they will have to let 4DR off with a warning this time. I totally get your point, man. Alright, looks like we will have a little bit of a pause coming out here. Pain might just need a little bit of time to reset, catch their breath, change their pants, and get it all together, because this is going to be competing for points going into the playoffs, so they really need to take a game off of Evernova here, and if not, it's going to be setting themselves up for a much harder tournament. Yeah, I mean, Pain, they're really far behind right now. How do they get themselves back in this? You talked about they need to fight with that Puck, they need to get a good Dreamcoil off, but it seems like Evernova, every single hero is just ahead of their counterpart on the side of the Dire. Looking at the net worth chart, Shadowfiend is almost doubling up Lifestealer's net worth. They're gonna go in. They are gonna drop the Finger of Death for it, and they will end up getting the dual victory out of it, so that's gonna be two duels in favor of Legion Commander, but meanwhile, there is gonna be Slardar getting a pick mid lane on the Darkseer. Still, worthwhile trade if we're averaging out the entire map, but I feel like Pain are just giving up free stuff that they shouldn't be. They need to back off here. Puck going in with the Lifestealer Bomb will be able to go in, get a nice Waning Rift, get a nice Silence onto two, and now Puck on the back lines is leaving 40R to fend for himself, but is the Lifesteal enough? It is not, as it's just going to be everyone getting ripped to shreds. Finally, the Witch Doctor Ultimate will secure the fate of the Puck as she once again dies. That is Puck's fourth death of the game. Second death, rather. I was clicked on the Lifestealer. But either way, Pain Gaming, they go in, they have a successful gank on the Shadow Fiend, but it cost them both their lives. Yeah, so you think Pain Gaming are just kind of tilting, sucking themselves out, just trying for really big YOLO plays that might not be it. Well, they are going to go for a smoke, maybe into the Roche Pit, maybe trying to scout out some kills. Because they are pinging out Slicks. They want to get this catch on that safe laner, but again, he has a double damage bottled up. He's almost finished with the Battle Fury. His net worth is astronomically higher than any of the Dire Heroes. It'll be a nice catch if they get it, but, well, it's going to be a difficult thing to lock down. Oh. Well, they're gonna get a brief breather. Yeah, the Roche is going to be slow, so what might happen is Evernova, they rip apart this tier 1, they go ahead, TP either to the tier 2 bot or the tier 1 mid and try to get this Roche on, because again, it's still about half health, and they've been whacking at it for 45 seconds. Now the tower is down, let's see if they want to push for a tier 2 or rotate back for the Roche, because they've got to realize that Pain are in the pit right now. It'd be a little bit silly to assume otherwise. Now the Roche on will end up going down in favor of the Dire. Who are they going to put it on? Looks like the Lifestealer? Yeah, Lifestealer will be dropping his items and picking that up, but tier 2 taking some heavy damage here from Hook, and let me go. Yeah, I mean, it is a little bit of, I wouldn't say misplay, I'd say like a situational thing that may not be the right thing to do in this situation, but Evernova still are holding on to a lead. They've stopped accelerating it astronomically, but they've got a little bit of wiggle room to work with, so even if they make a couple quirky plays, they make a couple awkward decisions, they are not going to be dramatically losing their grip here. They've got room to drop at least one or two fights before Pain really gain momentum. Oh, Hook! Just slithering on through, does scout out the Legion. I don't believe he found the lion waiting in the tree. So Lilkin being a sneaky boy, but now Radiant, they might be rotating resources here to stop the Legion Commander. Oh, they're going through. They will start a duel here onto King RD, and that's just not even going to work, as Hook is going to be healed up by the Oracle. Now Slicks is going to be in some serious trouble, might end up getting slapped down by 40R. In fact, he goes in for a sleight of fist. Is it going to be enough to save his life? It will be. For now, he's healing up. Derp, derp, dropping the ward. We'll be able to go through the ward. I don't believe we'll do a whole lot of damage after the respawn. Now 40R actually getting locked in place. That death ward doing everything. They get every last ounce of damage out of it, and 40R ends up falling twice in a row. Aegis down, Hero down. It's going to be a 3-0. Pain Gaming, oh man, that could have been a great initiation, but they lost it all. The only people that survived were the offlane Darkseer and the support Lion. They lost all their cores. Look at the ward vision on the Dire Jungle. Or on the Radiant Jungle, rather. Dire, they tried so hard to look at what's around them, but they still just kind of dove face first into a pile of heroes. So for now, it's going to be Pain Gaming trying to make up a lot of lost ground here. Leech Commander has picked up the Blink. We saw it unveiled a couple of fights ago, but even with the Blade Mail, she still feels underwhelming. She's hitting for, you know, like 140-something, but Ember Spirit now just chunking you down at over 200 damage a pop. He's got the Battle Fury, he's got the Booth of Travel, he's got 1400 gold to work with. Good lord, that is a scary hero, and we're only 23 minutes into the game. Oh, we got a Hurricane Pike on the field. Slardar. Yeah, certainly not hard at all. It adds a lot of oomph to his hits. Slardar going for the Lotus Orb here. Is that the right play, or does he need to build straight tank? Legion Commander wanted to be so scary there, showing her presence, going in with the press the attack, trying to find the kill into Witch Doctor, but Witch Doctor just shuffles away with the Voodoo Restoration on, and no duel to be had. King RD will go through and clear out the jungle creeps, but this Legion has just not become that zoning, unbelievably scary presence they were hoping for. That one hit, you could feel it. Puck was like, I don't want to go, I don't want to leave this way, but really didn't have a whole lot of choice here. They are going to be looking, trying to get the jump on to Let Me Go. Arrows are going to be off the mark. They do get the duel, and the Legion Commander is blade mailed out. They're throwing everything at Let Me Go, but it's not going to be enough. Let Me Go ends up living through it. They take out the Legion Commander. Everything is going right for Evernova. Nothing is going well for Pain Gaming on the back lines. Shadow Fiend will end up getting brought down here, but just immediate return of the damage, as the only survivor is Lifestealer, cowering up in this top lane, wanting nothing to do with the squabbles going down bottom. And now it's going to be all of Evernova, save the Shadow Fiend, barreling down, going for this tier 3, and, you know, Legion Commander has no buyback. Lion does, Puck does, is going to be respawning in 5 seconds anyway, but it's just a really bad place to be if you're Dire right now. Yeah, I mean, you're worrying about your base here at 27 minutes, and on a team with a Shadow Fiend and an Ember Spirit, it's only gonna get worse. Like, there's no way that Shadow Fiend just suddenly falls off, or Ember Spirit just decides to buy all the wrong items and misplay consistently. I mean, Evernova, they've shown themselves to be a very cohesive team, and Pain, I don't know if they're gonna be able to find mistakes to capitalize on. All right, so down bottom looks like 40R desperately looking for some push. He does have his SNY. He's gonna be building up that belt of strength, probably going into a basher here. I think that'd be a solid play. Now King RD is gonna be looking for the Desolator after picking up the Blightstone. Do you think that's what Legion needs to get back in this? Oh, Hook. Oh, the smoke is scouted out by the scan. Very good use, very good game sense from Evernova. Now the fight will continue as the Dire don't know they've been scanned. They're gonna hop down an observer ward. Now let me go, just laying in the damage. Linaro will end up burning down before the fight really even gets started. Lilkin following suit. Now let me go, could be the trade here. Jubaloo drops down a really nice wall, but he's just getting destroyed. Now Derp Derp gonna get munched on here by 40R, and looks like they might be able to get the kill onto the Witch Doctor. Witch Doctor somehow is still alive, taking through so much damage. Now 40R will be going down eventually, toggling the armlet for all it's worth, but it's gonna be a triple kill here for Slicks. This is getting really, really bad. Linaro still alive on the backlands, the fight bottling up, but there's no way you can reinitiate off of that. And so Legion Commander ends up getting back to base safely. Puck will be going through, going in, cleaning out the creep wave, cutting the wave a little bit, does have the TP scroll on the backlands of that though. A very successful fight for the Radiant. Slicks picking up a huge chunk of net worth off of that, and should be grabbing an Aegis as well. Well, up top there is going to be a duel coming out onto Slicks, but they just don't have the damage to get it done in time. The duel, okay, they get one last hit to get the duel victory for Legion. That's a very important kill. Pretty high bounty there, almost 900 gold going the way of Legion Commander, and that's going to be about a 1700 gold change in favor of Pain, but with such a huge deficit, that barely takes the edge off. Now Hook going to be going through, they will be able to get a kill onto King RD. Godlike streak for Hook. That guy is feeling good. Fish boys sometimes fail to itemize correctly, but I really do like the first pick armlet into the Lotus Orb after getting the blink. Let me go. Let me go, just lived through that. His lifesteal is pretty absurd here. Vacuum will not connect as Jubaloo incorrectly tabulates where they're gonna be. Now looks like Rage will make sure that Fortune Den doesn't come through. So it's just gonna be Pain cornered onto their high ground. The rest of the Radiant, aside from the dead Ember, are feeling relatively fight and fit. Everyone's got full health, full mana. They're ready to go and slap down the tower. Again, we do have Shadow Fiend with the Aegis and the Hurricane Pike, so he is ready to fight. Alright, well, looks like Pain, they're getting ready for a last stand here. They know it's going to be a last stand. Looking at buybacks, there's not a whole lot on the board. They're going to go through, get a little bit of a stun here onto 40R with the Searing Chains. And now Slicks will be going through, showing off that new Lincoln Sphere. So they're not going to be able to jump him the way they'd like. They got to pop it before they go in for the duel. Now they are going to go through. They get the nice pull here onto Let Me Go. But with the Manta, with the Requiem, they're ripping through everyone's health. Looks like 40 are moving the next to go down. They're going to get the puck as well. They have buyback on the Lifestealer, but no buyback on the puck. This is most likely going to be GG, as it's just going to be Pain shredding through, or rather, Evernova shredding through Pain's base. GG called out by King RD himself on the Jungle Legion, and it's going to be a 2-0 sweep in favor of Evernova. What went wrong with Pain's draft?